We will start our problem with a rectangle. Then, from the bottom left and the bottom right corner of the rectangle, we will pull two intersecting lines up until the random points on the upper side of the rectangle. And, in this way, we have formed two triangles. Now, if we know that the area of the bigger triangle is equal to 4 squared units, and the area of the smaller triangle is equal to 1 squared unit, can we somehow calculate the area of the whole rectangle? This problem was actually presented to me by one of my subscribers, Johnny86. So thank you, Johnny, for this wonderful suggestion. Of course, if you want to try this one for yourself, this would be a great time to pause the video and then come back and check the solution. Alright, so let's solve this one together. I will offer you two different methods to solve this particular problem. The first method will use the triangle similarity. So, we will start by labeling the vertices of the rectangle as A, B, C, and D. We will also label the intersection point between two lines as O, and we will label the remaining vertices of our smaller triangle as M and N. Now, we will use one really interesting property of angles forming by intersecting lines, which states that two angles which are formed by intersecting lines are actually equal. We can use this in our case since the lines MB and AN are intersecting lines. This means that two angles at the apex of our two triangles are actually equal. Next, we will use another mathematical property of angles in parallel lines. This property states that if we have two parallel lines and we pull another line through them, which is actually called a transversal, the each pair of corresponding angles on the same side of the intersecting transversal are equal to each other. Now, since our transversal is intersecting one of the parallel lines, we can conclude that the angle beneath this transversal is also equal as the angle above. Now, we can use this in our case. Since the lines AB and MN are parallel, and AN represents the transversal, we can say that the angles at the point N and the point A of our two triangles must be the same. This also applies for the other two angles at the point M and the point B. So, since our two triangles have the same angles, we can conclude that those two triangles are actually similar. Now, we can isolate them and use the rule of similarity. We know that the factor of similarity, which we will label as k, is equal to the square root of the relation between the areas of those two triangles. So, if we substitute our values and calculate, we will get that this factor is equal to 2. This actually means that our bigger triangle, ABO, has 2 times bigger sides than our smaller triangle, NMO. So, if we label the base of our big triangle as A, this means that the base of our smaller triangle must be A over 2. The same thing applies for the height. If we label the height of the bigger triangle as H, this means that the height of our smaller triangle must be H over 2. Alright, so now let's have a look at the line BC. It will represent the other side of our rectangle and we will label it as B. Now, if we set our attention to the heights of our two triangles and the line B, you can notice that the length of the line B is actually equal to the sum of the heights of our two triangles. Now, we can work through this and get that B is equal to 3h over 2. Now, if we make h a subject, we can say that h is equal to 2b over 3, and we can substitute this value in. Now, let's again have a closer look at the triangle ABO. We can calculate the area of this triangle as the product of the base and the height divided with 2. So, if we substitute the values from our sketch, we will get the following. Now we can work through this and get that this area is equal to A times B over 3. But from the condition of our problem, we know that the area of this triangle is equal to 4, so we can substitute this value in and finally get that the product of A and B must be equal to 12. Now, remember, we are looking for the area of our big red rectangle, which is actually equal to the product of its sides A and B. So, since we already have the value of A times B, we can conclude that the area of our wanted red rectangle is equal to 12 squared units, and this is our solution. Alright, so now let me show you the second method, which will use the relation between the triangle and the rectangle. We will start this method by first pulling the horizontal line through the intersection point between our two triangles. And in this way we will form two smaller rectangles. Now, from the previous method, in which we use the angles formed by intersecting lines and the angles formed by parallel lines, we know that those two triangles are actually similar. So, we also used the rule of similarity to say that the factor of similarity is equal to the square root of the relation between their areas, which we calculated to be equal to 2. This means that if we label the height of our bigger triangle as h, the height of our smaller triangle must be h over 2. Furthermore, we know that the height of those two triangles are actually equal to the height of our two rectangles. And we also know that those two rectangles share the same base, which we can label as b. Now, just as a quick reminder, if we have a rectangle with the base of B and the height of H, the area of this rectangle will be equal to the product of the base and height. Furthermore, if we inscribe the triangle inside the rectangle so that it shares the same base and the same height as a rectangle, the area of this triangle will be equal to the half of the area of the rectangle. Now, let's have a look at our blue rectangle. It also has the triangle, which has the same base and the same height. So this means that the area of the whole rectangle must be 2 times bigger than the area of our triangle. So, since our triangle has the area of 4, this means that our blue rectangle has the area of 8. Now we can say that this area is also equal to the base B times height H, which is of course equal to 8. This is important for us because if we try to find the area of our smaller green rectangle, we can find it as b times h over 2. So, since we already have the value of b times h to be equal to 8, we can substitute this in and get that our smaller rectangle has the area of 4. Now, since we're looking for the area of our big rectangle, it must be equal to the sum of the areas of two smaller rectangles, and if we substitute those values, we can conclude that the area of our big rectangle is equal to 12 squared units, and again, we have our solution. Well, I really hope you guys enjoyed this interesting problem. If you did, do not hesitate to leave a like or subscribe to the channel, it means a lot. And of course, if you found another way to solve this problem, please write it down in the comment section below. And of course, until next time, see you all and take care.